David Foster holds an event each year, a fundraiser for children and organ transplants. This year is at the Fallsview Casino in Niagara Falls. I'm doing two nights, so back to back, Friday, Saturday. So the staff has been prepping all week long for this event.
I am making 4,200 pieces. Are you okay?
You look tired, babe.
Yeah.
Friday night is a more intimate evening.
I'm gonna ask everybody to sing one song.
We're about an hour off our march.
I lost total control of the timeline.
We should let them serve. I was thinking screw.
I have never had a break like that in 20 years.
He's a genius, this guy.
If you gave me $1 billion and said make that dinner, I wouldn't know where to begin.
Thank you for all your hard work.
The difficulty is we finish on Friday. I have to do the complete physical setup for Saturday, which is 1,000 people plated.
I'm gonna queue up the stewarding now that physically we're set for the morning, and then we're off to the races. Everybody just has to listen. I will show you exactly how to place it.
Saturday is a huge night.
Here's our window for dinner.
And then the timeline's so tight.
6:18, we're down to 7:10.
What?
Like, we really have to nail it.
Now you gotta speed up, Jim. You gotta push it out. Let's go, let's go.
My whole mission is not to eat something that's fantastic. So accomplishing that for a large number, under duress, is always the challenge, right?
Holy f***.
I'm dead. It's gonna be crazy.
Just push him underneath.
Johnny, how you doing? Okay? All right. They're in bed by 1 last night, so for them, they're still young bloods. They get 5 hours, they reboot. I was a bit weary this morning. I have to nail the structural service. Like, every line has to be inched out, because if it doesn't fit when you're under pressure, it won't work. Sasha's getting all the big stuff done. The gnocchi fried, the carrots done, the Swiss chard done, and compartmentalizing all that, so when all the students arrive at 12, what we'll do is we'll piece them off into little tag teams and give them each duties to do.
Because I have 60 students arriving at 12 o'clock. The students are gonna be really helpful. I don't have enough cooks to do a plate service for 1,000 people, so they're gonna be my right arm that night. And this night is just gonna scare the hell out of them. They're all gonna look at me with these big cow eyes, and they're gonna want a job to do. And I'm gonna have to make them understand the day.
Each line is sort of measured out to the inch, so it fits the pans perfectly. Like, if you don't space these right and the containers come out and they don't work, everybody gets panicked. If they don't have the right spoon, they get panicked. So I'm gonna just completely do it for everybody.
And even then, it's gonna be crazy when it starts. Because the hallway looks big when it's empty, but you put 100 servers in it, 50 cooks, 20 support staff, that'll look like a busy street in New York at 5 o'clock.
You have to really think it through mechanically, as well as cook well. Students are arriving now. As they walk in the door, we're gonna grab them and put them in teams.
So I'm gonna pair them up with my staff and the casino staff.
What I wanna show everyone is how we're gonna plug into the line. So when I cue everybody up for service, you go exactly to that spot. You remember exactly what I told you. The main concern is that everyone understands exactly the one move that they have to make and how they fit into the puzzle.
Go behind, I want 5 on a side. Put yourself down right here. You're bison, you're doing carrots.
Can I get 2 cooks from here, please? Now, each one of these lines is an exact mirror of the other. I have A, B, and C. From the kitchen will arrive gnocchi, Swiss chard, variegated carrots, bison, sauce, spiced apples, and thyme. Write your name down on your tag. Everybody just has to listen and execute one move and dovetail with the person next to you. I will show you exactly how to place it.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 2006 David Foster and Friends Charity Gala. This is an extraordinary cause. This is going to be an extraordinary night. Please welcome Michael Goff.
Very shortly, you'll be served an outstanding dinner prepared by Mark McEwen and his team.
Go. Let's go. Start moving. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. You gotta go twice that fast, okay? Start coming in, let's go. 2 at a time, 2 at a time. I can take more down here, please. You can pick up and move this way from here, okay?
I need no mango.
You're gonna get a salad for them. Oh, these
Special orders drive you crazy. We have salads coming.
Yeah. Waiters, start picking up. Make sure there's soup in the
bowl. Here we can pick up, ladies and gentlemen. Come on. Start picking up here. We're going this way. To this gentleman's right, you can pick up. Come on. Make sure they pick up here. Watch the bottom of the bucket. Lift it up. Lift it up, man. Come on. Pay attention to what you're doing. Guys, fill the soup less.
Less.
Less. Fill the soup less. Okay? Halfway only.
It was wild. There was a couple moments there when I was watching all the food come out to the lines and all the chefs are on each station.
You look at all these great food magazines, make the plate look like that, okay? That's what we all get paid for.
There's just this massive movement of bodies in this hallway.
Plates, please. Plates, please.
It was frightening.
No, no, no. Put the bowl down. Just like this, okay? Even just do three.
Just three.
Just three. Just three. Just do three. Do three only. Three gnocchi only, okay? Three gnocchi only. I know. I changed my mind, okay?
The hardest part was to get the stylized main course plate the way I wanted it.
Just do a little bit. Little tiny bit, okay?
It took about 30 plates going off each line before they started to get the plate, and I was surprised by that.
You're gonna take a little bit of Swiss chard. It's gonna be like so. I don't want anything on the edge of the plate, okay? You're gonna put your bison like that. You do your apple, like so. You do your thyme, like so.
They had some senior people there from different establishments that were at sort of the end of the line, so I was leaning on them to tweak the plate and talk to everybody, but I think just the scale of the day and the intensity of the day sort of caught everybody by surprise.
Now you gotta speed up, Jim. You gotta push it out. Let's go, let's go.
It's tough because just when you think everything's under control. Holy I'm dead. I'm gonna have to do a little yelling and screaming.
Just push him underneath.
Now what it is it's a deep bowl and it will oscillate. It's sort of, they sit and they'll just all of a sudden change direction.
Freaking plates, huh?
It's a technical glitch.
You gotta be careful. Twice in one f-ing day. Guys, you have Swiss chard? How much more do we have?
Just the last one, Seth.
That's the last you have?
Yes.
Swiss chard, take it out. Tell them to cut way down on the amount.
Once in a while, you'll get tripped up.
Very little Swiss chard, okay? Almost nothing.